Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. Today I'm talking about dividing decimals. Division is the most complicated of the operations for decimals, much as it is the most complicated operation for whole numbers. So we're going to look at several examples, and I'm actually going to do them on another piece of paper. I've got the answers here so that you can read through them, but if you would like to see the detail, please watch me as I work it out on paper. So in the first example, we don't have a divisor that's a decimal number. Our divisor is a whole number, and that's the easiest type. So when we have that, we're just going to divide like we would normally, and then we're going to bring the decimal point straight up into the answer. So 3 goes into 10 three times. We're going to bring that decimal point straight up. 3 times 3 is 9, and if I subtract, I get 15. 3 goes into 15. 5 times, and I get 3.5. That's all there is to it. If I had been asked to round, I wouldn't need to round to the tenths because it stopped exactly at the tenths. In a little more difficult example, we have division with a decimal number. So the divisor is a decimal number, and we always want to move the decimal point to make the divisor a whole number. In this case, we need to move it one place. But if you move that for the divisor, you have to do the same thing for the dividend. So then I'm asked to round to the hundreds. That was on the other paper, so I'll just say I'm rounding that to the hundreds. So we need to go out three places so that we can round back to the second place, which is the hundreds. That's why I put three trailing zeros on there to begin with. Okay, so I want to just remember that the decimal point is going to come straight up into my answer. I don't need to put that decimal point there, but I just did to show you where it was. 51 doesn't go into 1 or 15, but it goes into 159 three times. And 3 times 51 is 153. I'm going to subtract. So this is just the division that you know and love from before. Always I'm bringing down that next number. 51 goes into 60 one time, and then I subtract again. That gives me 9, and I bring down the next one. 51 goes into 90 one time, and 1 times 51 is 51. 90 minus 51 is 39, and then I bring down that final zero. And then how many times does 51 go into 390? Well, it turns out that it goes 7 times. 7 times 51 is 357. And I don't really care about the rest of that because I was only asked to round to the hundreds. This is far enough. I went out three places. Now I can round back, and I can see that my answer should be 3 and 12 hundredths when I round it. All right, in the next example, we have 3 decimal places in our divisor. So we're going to move that 3 places. And we're going to move the decimal place 3 places for the dividend as well. But remember, if you have to move it 3 places and you only have 2, then you've got to add a 0 before you put that decimal point down. So I move that 3, I move that 3, and then that decimal point comes straight up into my answer. It's nice to keep things lined up nicely here. So then 4 goes into 8 twice, bring down the 2. It does not go into 2, so I put a 0. Then bring your 3 down. 4 goes into 23 5 times. I'm going through the division quickly because this is a skill you already have. Bring down the 0. 4 goes into 37 times, that would be 28, and then 30 minus 28 is 2. I'm going to bring down the next 0, that's this one. 4 goes into 25 times, and now I don't need to worry about anything else. I know all I have left is zeros, so it's just I can put as many zeros as I want on there. If I was specifically asked to round to the hundreds place, my answer should be 2,057 and 50 hundredths. Many instructors would not care if you just had 0.5 there, but this one specifically said go to the hundredths, so that's what I'm going to do. Okay, in our last example, I want to remind you that when you're doing decimal division, you may have a number that's the divisor that's greater than what you're dividing into or the dividend. And so here I have 18.1 into 9.235. I have 1 decimal place to move over to make that a whole number, So I move this one place. Then I have 181. Remember, my decimal point would be there. And I have now 92.35. And I add one more zero. And I'm doing that because specifically in my examples, I'm saying round to the hundreds. So I go out three places so I can round back to that second place. You may be asked to round to the tens, in which case you would only go out two places. Or if you were asked to round to the millionth, you'd go out seven places and round back. Wherever you asked to round to, you go out one extra place from there. Now I'm going to go through this. 181 doesn't go into 92, so I definitely have a zero there. 181 goes into 923 five times. In 5 times 181, I did that earlier. Use your calculator to check this. There's no reason that you're doing all kinds of long calculations here. I get 905. And when I subtract that, I get 185. Now I can see that 181 goes into 185 one time. That one I can do in my head. 5 minus 1 is 4. Bring that down. And 181 goes into 40 zero times. That's as far as I need to go because I'm only rounding to the hundreds. Because zero is here, that one doesn't change, and my answer is 0 and 51 hundredths. All right, that's it for division. I hope you have a fantastic day.